guys, you're welcome back. Hope you guys are doing great. So a Jewish child causes more than 6,000 Jews and Christians in France to convert to Islam. So let's check it out.
Hi everyone. This true story, which happened more than half a century ago, is about a 10 years old Jewish child who lived in France. There was an old man who used to work in a shop. This man of Turkish origin lived in France and his name was Sheikh Ibrahim. He worked in a grocery store selling goods and many people would usually buy from him. This grocery store was in a building and in one of its apartments lived a Jewish family. This family had a 10 years old little boy named Jad. This child would always go to the shop to buy from this old sheikh, and every time he bought something, he would steal small chocolates and hide them among the things. Although Sheikh Ibrahim knew about him, he would always keep silent, with a jovial smile. And in one of the following days, as Jad visited the shop, he forgot to steal the piece of chocolates. So Sheikh Ibrahim said to him, "You steal these chocolates every day, though you forgot to take it today." The child knew that he was guilty and that the sheikh knew about his wrongdoings. He got scared and asked, "Do you know about me?" "Yes, I know," said the sheikh with a smile. Jad then said to him, "What will you do with me? Will you inform the police about me or will you tell my family?" "No, but I have one condition," said the sheikh. Jad said, "What is it?" Sheikh Ibrahim then said, "My condition is that you don't steal from me or anyone else from today onwards. And if you promise me this, I'll forgive you. I promise you," said Jad. Sheikh Ibrahim said, "Well, then go and I'll give you chocolates every day without you having to steal it." The child had never felt this type of joy, at least for him. If it were someone else, he would have scolded him, shouted at him, and kicked him out of the shop, but he treated him in this manner. The child loved this old sheikh. He bought things from him every day and would talk and joke with him on the daily. The child became attached to this sheikh. The years passed and the child grew little by little and became a young man. And as young people in Europe are going through problems, Jad would have the solution for his own problems and hardships. He would turn to whom? To the old sheikh. He would sit down with him and complain and tell him about the worries in his chest. So neither his father nor his mother and friends could benefit him like this sheikh. And when the young Frenchman arrived and sat down, he started to complain about his distress. The sheikh then told him to wait. When he came back, he arrived with a box. He opened the box and brought out a book for him. Jad didn't know the story of this book. Sheikh Ibrahim gave the book to Jad and told him to open any random page. Jad opened the page and told him to go ahead. Sheikh Ibrahim then started to read, and as they read the two pages, he explains them to Jad and finds a solution to the problem through the two pages. As Jad was wondering what this book was, he thought to himself, "If I had a problem and opened any two pages, I would find the solution." One day, as Jad visited the shop, he realized that the sheikh was absent. Jad asked about him and discovered that he was sick and in the hospital. It was only a few days ago when that man, Sheikh Ibrahim Al-Turki, died that day. Before he died, he told his children to not open the box and instead give it as a gift from me to that young man whose name is Jad, and say to him, "This is a gift from Sheikh Ibrahim." When young Jad came sadly to console his friends and the children of Sheikh Ibrahim, they took to him to his side and told him, "Our father gave you a gift before he died." He hadn't known that it was the Quran. As days and weeks passed, Jad would fall into trouble and hardship. But this time, he didn't know who to turn to. Sheikh Ibrahim had died. Whom should I go to? Jad remembered the gift and went to the box and opened it and took out the book. Jad didn't know until now that it was the Quran, but he didn't know how to read it. He went with this Quran to search for one of his Arab friends. And luckily, he found a Tunisian friend in France who knew Arabic and French. He told him, "This book, I want to read two pages from it. Can you open it and explain it to me?" The man agreed and opened two pages and started to translate it to French. As the pages were translated, Jad started to cry because he found the solution to his problem in those two pages. Jad said in confusion, "What is this strange book?" The man then said, "No, this is our book, a book from God. It is the Quran, the book of Muslims." "To whom is this book?" Jad said. God sent it down to our Prophet Muhammad, and it became a light and guidance for the world, said the man. At that moment, Jad knew that this Quran was the solution to all his problems for many years. Jad then told him how to become Muslim. He told him to repeat after him, I bear witness that there is no God except Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Jad officially entered the religion of God, Islam. Jad was in his 20s at that time, and he began to learn Islam and became one of the best callers to God in Europe. And in a few years, 6,000 people in Europe embraced Islam at his hand. There had been a piece of paper inside the box that Sheikh Ibrahim had gave him. And on the paper, the Sheikh had written a verse which said, That is my way, I invite to Allah with insight. He then decided to travel to Africa and called himself Jadal al-Qur'ani. He remained for 30 years calling for God, and in those years he converted millions to Islam. Because of whom? Because of Sheikh Ibrahim, the owner of Good Manners and the owner of the shop. Jadallah passed away in 2003, about 20 years ago, and he was the reason for the entry for millions of people to the true religion of God, Islam. The advice I have for you, dear brothers and sisters, is to read a few pages of this miraculous book, because I am sure it will have a positive impact in your life. My friends, please like, share, and subscribe. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وله الحمد في الآخرة وهو الحكيم الخبير يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو الرحيم الغفور وقال الذين كفروا لا تأتينا الساعة قل بلى وربي لتأتينكم عالم الغيب لا يعزب عنه مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض ولا أصغر من ذلك ولا أصغر من ذلك ولا أكبر إلا في كتاب مبين ليجزي الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم والذين سعوا في آياتنا معاجزين أولئك لهم عذاب من رجز أليم ويرى الذين أوتوا العلم الذي أنزل إليك من ربك هو الحق ويهدي ويرى الذين أوتوا العلم الذي أنزل إليك من ربك هو الحق ويهدي إلى صراط العزيز الحميد وقال الذين كفروا هل ندلكم على رجل ينبئكم إذا مزقتم كل ممزق إنكم لفي خلق جديد أفترى على الله كذبا أم به جنة بل الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة في العذاب والضلال البعيد أفلم يروا إلى ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم من السماء والأرض إن نشأ نخسف بهم الأرض أو نسقط عليهم كسفا من السماء إن في ذلك لآية لكل عبد منيب ولقد آتينا داود منا فضلا
يا جبال أوبي معه والطير وألنا له الحديد أن اعمل سابغات وقدر في السرد واعملوا صالحا إني بما تعملون بصير ولسليمان الريح غدوها شهر ورواحها شهر وأسلنا له عين القطر ومن الجن من يعمل بين يديه بإذن ربه ومن يزغ منهم عن أمرنا نذقه من عذاب السعير يعملون له ما يشاء من محاريب وتماثيل وجفان كالجواب وقدور الراسيات اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور فلما قضينا عليه الموت ما دلهم على موته إلا دابة الأرض تأكل من سأته فلما خر تبينت الجن أن لو كانوا يعلمون الغيب ما لبثوا في العذاب المهين.
Wow, amazing story, guys. I love how the old, you know, journey started. I love how it all started. You know, what really caught my attention was the fact that he saw the book that was hidden in the box, and that was the Quran. And the fact that he was very interested in it is like, that was really cool. Like, it came to me as a surprise that he was determined to learn more. And his friend of him, his friend assisted him in reading the Quran, and that changed his life. And that was how the whole thing happened. Then many people converted through him. Amazing, amazing story. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.